What's up, burritos? Carne Asada here, and welcome back to Skyrim. So we finally made it to Iverstead, which means that we are that much closer to getting up to the Greybeards and learning our next word of power. So let's go ahead and just get on up those 7,000 steps, why don't we? Just this way, I believe. It's so foggy lately. My goodness. Hopefully it'll clear up.
7,000 steps again, Clement?
Not today. I'm just not ready to make the climb to High Hrothgar. The path isn't safe.
That doesn't bode well.
Aren't the Greybeards expecting some supplies?
Honestly, I'm not certain. I've yet to be allowed into the monastery. Perhaps one day.
I wish
I could make my deliveries more often, but the road's getting dangerous.
Is it?
Passing through on your way to High Hrothgar? About to make a delivery up there myself.
What types of deliveries do you make to High Hrothgar?
Mostly food supplies like dried fish and salted meats. You know, things that keep fresh for a long time.
True.
The Greybeards tend not to get out much, if you catch my meaning.
I think so. And what do they do for you?
Well, it's kind of an understanding between us. I mean, it just wouldn't feel right to charge them for a bit of preserved food.
I suppose.
The trouble is, my legs aren't what they used to be, and climbing the 7,000 steps takes its toll.
I can imagine. That sounds like the worst case of tread climber I've ever heard in my life. I mean, I have to go up there anyway. I suppose I could do it.
Really? Well, that would be kind of you.
Oh, no problem.
Here, take this bag of supplies. At the top of the steps, you'll see the offering chest. Just leave the bag inside, and you're done.
Oh, well, that's easy enough. All right.
Be careful up there.
Will do. So let's begin our long trek up the 7,000 steps to get to High Hrothgar and speak with the Greybeards. I mean, they did shout so very far away from me, so I suppose they must need me. Boots! I want to go. I'm gonna take that. I'm gonna save all the goat horns I can, because they're super important when you go to build your house, I found out. Oh, puppy! I misjudged that one a little bit. Got there a little early. Oopsies. So what foul beastie should we expect on this walk here? It's quite a large amount of steps when you think about it. Who sat there and counted them all? That's my question. Go get the other one. Did you shot it in the butt? Nice. Good butt shot there. You just saved us from potentially losing a meal. Oh, hey! Who are you?
Keep an eye on Bargnar. If you're headed up the path to High Hrothgar.
Did you hear them yell Dovahkiin?
I did. Strange days when the monks will do that. I wonder what it means.
What you doing?
I like to spend time up here. Walk the steps. Meditate on the emblems. Doesn't hurt when I bag some game along the way.
No, I'm doing the same thing.
Until next time.
Yep, until next time. Oh, the fog is finally cleared. That's wonderful. That's absolutely wonderful. It's good to see that we can actually see. Oh, it's actually kind of pretty down there. In a weird sort of oddly not very well-defined way. What's this? Puppy! Ooh, ice wolves are way stronger. Damn, did I just kick it in the throat? Awesome. I'm gonna take that. Oh, and we leveled up too, even better. So let's put some into stamina now? I think that would be good, because I think stamina raises your carrying capacity. And now we have our heavy armor up there. Take half damage from falling. Nah, I'm good. What can we do with our one-handed, though? Dual-wielding attacks are 20% faster. No, I think we're good in that department. We're good in that department for now. We can't quite level Resto yet, but I should just hold on to this perk until we hit level 20 with Resto. That way I can buff it. Which way are we going again? I'm getting lost. There we go. But yeah, it'd be nice to have slightly stronger restoration spells until I can get fast healing or something like that. And then we can start working on enchanting and alteration once I can get an alteration spell that's worth it. Because it's nice to, with enchanting, there's a perk that if you're holding a weapon in one hand and a spell in the other, they're both 20% more powerful, which, again, very nice for, you know, like a Resto Paladin or a Frost. Ooh. Give me horns. Nope. Just a bunch of goat hide. But that's fine, because that's leather, and that's experience. Nice. Just keep hunting goats. I think you still get XP for, like, one-handed and stuff like that when you do that. Oh, I need to work on speech. That's right. With the mod that I'm using, speech gets XP when you shout. And that's basically free XP for me running around and shouting all the time, isn't it? And there's a few other really nice perks in there that help out with shouting, too. And since, you know, we have the mod in there that gives vendors a bit more gold, which makes it a little easier, I can sell some of the more expensive stuff more often, and that raises my speech skill too, so that'll be great. And I think there's one that actually raises the damage of my shouts, or the longevity of the effects cast by shouts. So we'll work on that right after I level up my restoration, because I feel like that's slightly more important to me right now, is to have a stronger restoration spell. Ah, what a nice walk this has been. Just a soothing little journey. And who might you be?
Need something?
Karita.
Yes?
What you doing?
Walking the steps, meditating on the emblems. I make this trip every few years.
Do you now? Oh, alright. Have fun. Bye to you too. Enjoy yourself. I'm not seeing too much foul beasties or too much anything on this trip, actually. It's rather calm. Nothing to see here. Just enjoying our walk. If I recall, trolls kind of say, hey, Lydia, help. You deal with that. Oh, that did nothing. Oh, man. No, don't hurt me. Ooh. Oh, man. Gonna need more help. Gonna need way more help. Hey, you down here? Do you mind maybe giving me a hand? Where are you? I need help. The troll's still coming. The troll is still coming. It's healing, that's right. Trolls heal naturally. Keep its attention. Oh my god. She's running away. Just keep my distance from it and keep kiting it and just. Oh boy. Yeah, we got it. Wow, that was. Ooh. Troll pelt. Cool. That was way harder than I thought it would be, and you were no help. You were no help whatsoever.
Keep an eye out for wolves if you're headed up the path to High Hrothgar.
Really? That's your advice? That's the scariest thing we might encounter? Wolves? Thanks, Karita. No, nothing to worry about with trolls. We just killed the only one up here, I'm sure of it. It's not like they move in packs or anything like that. Man, I am a little bit underleveled for things. Again, I'm so used to being able to just kind of flick things to death with my other character. But that other character is walking proof that the build that I am showing you guys will in fact work and work well. I'm gonna sprint a little bit and try to save some time here. Not that it'll do too much for us. We gotta be getting close though. Can't be that much further. I think it's just around the corner up here. Nope. No, it's not. It's just more steps. Le sai. I really hope there's no more trolls, though. I don't know if we're going to be as lucky as we were with the last one, having somebody who can kind of keep his attention briefly. The winds are getting stronger. There's a mod that makes it so, like, snowstorms will blind you and stuff like that, and I thought about it, but I don't know if I want to deal with that, especially in situations like this. Imagine if a snowstorm hit us while we were fighting that troll, we would have been in so much trouble. Hopefully I don't sound all nasally to you guys, too. I can't really tell. I can't really hear my own voice with my headset on, but the landscaping guys came through here today. Messed me up again. I really need to get some allergy meds that don't make me so drowsy. I could take a Benadryl, but you guys know I wouldn't be able to put an episode out for you if I did. I'd be sleeping all day. Oh, we did it. We finally made it. Hi, Hrothgar. So I guess we just put the baggie of supplies in a chest, and then we just kind of go inside. Yay! We did it! I'd assume it's under food? No? Miscellaneous? Yes, okay. Nice! Alright, so return to Klimek. Can I take this? Yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna keep that cure disease potion on me. Probably not a bad idea, considering how I like to come across vampires when they are not good for my health. Ah, so here we are, home of the Greybeards. And who do we have here?
So, a dragonborn appears at this moment in the turning of the age.
I do, I think. What does being a dragonborn mean?
First, let us see if you truly are dragonborn. Let us taste of your voice.
Okay.
Boosh! Shout at us. Dragonborn, it is you. Welcome to High Hrothgar.
Well, thank you for inviting me into your home.
I am Master Arngeir. I speak for the Greybeards. Now, tell me, dragonborn, why have you come here?
Because you shouted from miles away, as loud as humanly possible, asking me to come here?
We are honored to welcome a dragonborn to High Hrothgar. We will do our best to teach you how to use your gift in fulfillment of your destiny.
I would appreciate it. What is my destiny?
That is for you to discover. We can show you the way, but not your destination.
Sounds like Apple Maps. I'm ready to learn.
You have shown that you are dragonborn. You have the inborn gift.
I do.
But do you have the discipline and temperament to follow the path laid out for you? That remains to be seen.
I guess we'll find out.
Training, you have already taken the first steps towards projecting your voice into a thoom, a shout. Now let us see if you are willing and able to learn.
Well, I am willing to learn.
You shout, you speak in the language of dragons. Thus, your dragon blood gives you an inborn ability to learn words of power.
Excellent.
All shouts are made up of three words of power. As you master each word, your shout will become progressively stronger. Master Einarth will now teach you Ro, the second word in Unrelenting Force.
Thank you, Masters.
Ro means balance.
Lydia, please get out of the way. Respect your elders.
Force to focus your thumb more sharply.
Ooh. Ooh. Floor words. Come on. Let me learn you.
You learn a new word like a master. You truly do have the gift.
I suppose I do.
Learning a word of power is only the first step. You must unlock its meaning through constant practice in order to use it in a shout. Well, that is how the rest of us learn shouts. As Dragonborn, you can absorb a slain dragon's life force and knowledge directly. As part of your initiation, Master Einarth will allow you to tap into his understanding of Rome.
Ooh! Thank you, Master Einarth. You may want to get out of the way, Lydia.
Use your unrelenting force shout to strike the targets as they appear.
Gladly. What did I tell you, Lydia? Out of the way.
Well done. Again.
Okay. That's two. Okay. Uno más.
You learn quickly. Once more.
Alrighty then. Lydia's just not learning, is she? Or maybe she likes getting foosed.
Your thumb is precise. You show great promise, Dragonborn.
Thank you. Now what?
We will perform your next trial in the courtyard. Follow Master Bori.
Okay. You know what, since I'm learning all these shouts, perhaps it would behoove me to get the speech now. Where's speech? Speech. I think it's End the Universe Listens. Shouting restores points of health, magic, and stamina equal to your shout cooldown in seconds. You gain speech experience when shouting based on your shout cooldown. Oh my god. Based on the cooldown. So some of those long cooldown shouts, like the 100 second or the 200 second shouts, could heal me for a lot. Nice. Plus also having the selling bonus is nice too. Oh, and the performer perk. Ooh, I'm having a hard time with my P's. That's pretty nice too, because basically you get to be a bard and you can make music by getting large crowds together and dancing in front of them. And you get paid and riches and monies and necklaces and apples. Alright, everybody, come on. Doth you need to be so slow? One would hope not.
You will now see how you learn a completely new shout.
Okay.
Master Bori will teach you Wuld, which means whirlwind.
Alright, out with it, Bori. Ooh. Ooh, floor words.
You must hear the word within yourself before you can project it into a thumb. Approach Master Bori and he will gift you his knowledge of Wuld.
Hi, Bori. Ooh. All right. So that should mean... Yay! New shout.
Now we will see how quickly you can master a new shout.
Gladly.
Master Wulfgar will demonstrate whirlwind sprint. Then it will be your turn.
All right, well, go for it.
Now it's your turn. Stand next to me. Master Bori will open the gate. Use your whirlwind sprint to pass through before it closes.
Okay. I'm ready. Whee! Oh. Oh, sorry, Wolfgar. Just about mowed you over, didn't I?
Your quick mastery of a new Thum is astonishing. I'd heard the stories of the abilities of Dragonborn, but to see it for myself?
Awesome, aren't I? Thank you. What's next?
You are now ready for your last trial. Retrieve the horn of Jürgen Windcaller, our founder, from his tomb in the ancient fane of Ustengrav. Remain true to the way of the voice, and you will return.
Sounds good. Well, I don't need to ask you any questions. I need to get myself moving. So Ustengrav is up by Morthal. So what I'll do is I will fast travel to the Whitewind Stables. So we'll see you there. And here we are. So now we gotta go find the carriage driver who's not in his seat again. Sir? Sir? I would like a ride. Oh, hi.
Good evening.
Hello. Hmm? I'd like a ride. Morthal, please.
Climb and back and we'll be off.
Okay.
You ever met one of them cats? Khajiit, I think they called themselves. I hear there's whole...
And we found Morthal. So now we're that much closer to Ustengrav, so let's go ahead and take the long march. I doubt there's anything really of worth here for us. Perhaps we'll find some new gear down there in Morthal. Make ourselves a little bit stronger, some decent armor, because that troll almost wrecked us. Even though I have a 40% bonus to my heavy armor. It'd be good if we, get something done. Well, I wonder what this cave is. Maybe it'd be worth checking out this cave. I don't know. If it looks too dangerous, we'll just stay away from it. But who knows? Might be worth a shot. Oh, yeah, no. Anything with lair on it doesn't sound pleasing to me. Let's just get ourselves to Ustengrav and call it a day. I don't want to deal with anybody's lairs. It's all foggy again. Why can't I escape this fog? Is it common to see fog where there's a lot of cold? I would think not. I could be wrong, though. Oh! Mud crab! Yes, that is how it's done. Let's just get across the water here. Oh, that is super useful. I don't have to swim, I don't have to do nothing, I just kinda poof, and then there I am. So Ustengrav. Alright.
Did you hear something?
No. Is there something? Oh jeez. Stay away. That's awfully cold. Leave me alone! Necromancer? What's a necromancer doing with these guys? Is this telling of what I may be experiencing up here? No, those are all fur. Oh, come on. Would somebody just have some heavy armor, for goodness sake? That's all I'm asking for, is a little bit of better armor. Oh, well, maybe we'll find some in here. Let's take a look. Droop. No. Nothing good there. You got anything? No. What a shame. What a darned shame.
Huh?
Huh? What, Lydia? What? You got something to say? No? Alright. Let's figure out what's going on in here. Who are you? Let's get in for a closer look. Necromancers don't stand a chance against me. Oh, frostbite. Nice. Oh, come on. Just something a little better. It doesn't have to be a lot better. Bound sword. Awesome. Well, I could always start, like, conjure familiar. My goodness. I'm getting all types of spell books from here. Aw, yes. I could go into conjuration and start learning how to do conjuration of the bound weapons. That might actually be better for me, who knows? Uh-oh, sounds like somebody woke the Draugrs up. Uh-oh. I almost accidentally wolded all over the place. Oh, let me change. Restless Draugrs! Alright, so we took all of them out. Anything of value for me? Not really. Doesn't seem like anybody's willing to give me anything decent. Oh, silver ingot's not bad. Let's see, any potions? Potion of health, that's good. Always need those. Keeps me out of trouble. For when I can't quite restore my health fast enough. So it wants us to go that way, but it looks like there's something I can do in this way. Let's see. Potion. Check. Chest. An enchanter's potion's not too helpful for me, but whatever. Let's see, there's some stuff over this way too. Yay, minor healing. Potion of Glibinus. What's this? Mysteries of Talaria. Woo! Free Resto! That sounds great. Now I'm 21 with Restoration. That helps me out quite a bit, because that means that next time I level up, I can pick that perk if I want to. I probably should, but I also want that Shout perk. That would also be nice to have, so I'm a little torn. Anything down here? Yay. Tankards I don't need, but I'll just drop those later if I have too much weight in my inventory. Uh-oh. Oh, that's right. I didn't change it yet. Forgot. Just sprinted into a wall. Stop being cold. I don't like it when you do that. Listen, I don't have any protection on my arms, and it's cold, and you're giving me goosebumps, and you should just stop that. You should just stop that. There we go. And what do we got here? Illusion, minor healing, some arrows. Don't need the iron gauntlets, already wearing a pair myself. Need to find some steel or something. I don't know, something with some actual protection behind it. Well, we're through the first area, so... Oh, what? Goodness, you whine a lot, Lydia. So what have we down here? Ooh. That looks nice. Well, sure, they are, but that's not our problem right now. There goes a drauga. I don't need your bow. I don't do the bow thing. It's kind of not. Ow, fire! Get right into the thick of things. Oops, I didn't mean to pick that up. Oh well. Ow, cold. Ooh, cold. Just counter his spell with my spell. And basically just get XP off of it. Nice. Death to the Draugr. Man, come on, people. Give me something good. Something I can actually use. Loot is not being kind to me on this playthrough. Well, I can just go ahead and... Well, that only opened one door. I need to open two doors. Ah, there's the other one. Oh, hello! A little bit of damage. Yeah! Just smash your face in. Awesome. So now that door should be open, and I think I saw a chest in there. Oh, yeah! I did! Another orcish war axe? Come on. Well, I can give it to Lydia, and she'll have something a little stronger now. Sounds good. Lydia! Hi!
I've got your back.
I need to trade some things with you. Okay. Oh yeah, you still have dragon bones. Forgot about that. Nice. Now we got the same axe. Battle buddies to the end. Come on, give me better loot. Anything up here? No. Okay, we keep moving then. Oh, this place is nice and open. A yelling wall. Yes! Get a new shout.
What was that?
Bad skeleton. Bad. Ooh, potion. No, skeleton. No. Lydia, just keep them busy. I want to go down here and learn a new shout. Sadly, I don't have any dragon souls, so I can't actually equip said new shout. But hey, it would be nice to have anyway for the next dragon I encounter. Become ethereal, that's right. Now, if I remember, there's something behind this waterfall, too. Yep. No. You know, I'm getting a little disappointed at the lack of awesome in these chests. It's just like potions and stuff that I don't necessarily need. Making me a little sad. I need to really up my stamina, don't I? What to do now? Looks like Lydia went and took out all those skeletons except for one. Good on ya. Nope. I think not. I will be going this way, thank you very much. It doesn't appear to be the way I need to be going. Oh, that's right, there's that bridge over there, huh? That's the way I need to be going. Are we almost done with this dungeon? This one is huge. Nice. One hit. Power attacks. Sometimes I actually remember to use them. Sometimes I use them on accident. Alright, now to get through here, you have to pass all these stones. Well, the best way to do that is to actually, from what I've learned, it's just start sprinting and trigger the first one or two, and then wold your way through. Seems to be moving around. I don't like that. There's a spoder up here, isn't there? I don't like spoders. Alright, if we move carefully. Ouch. Spoders. Hello. Come here, spoders. Ooh. Ooh. Let's see if we can get them to cross the path of the fire and just roast themselves. It seems Lydia's better at that than anybody. Ooh! This is one of them big ones. I don't like the big ones. Alright, you're dealt with. All the spiders seem to be done. Let's just get through here. We gotta be getting close to the end, right? Gotta be. Neither have I, Lydia. Goodness. This is some impressive technology going on in here for medieval times. Dragonborn, I need to speak to you urgently. Rent the attic room at the Sleeping Giant Inn in Riverwood, and I'll meet you. A friend. Well, who might that be? I don't have any friends. Not to my knowledge. Are there any chests or anything in here? Something I can have? Something making this trip worth it? Yo, yay! Oh my. A fur collar? Sure, I'll take it. I'm gonna look schmancy. Aw, yes. That's awesome. A loose one would probably look better, but you know what? I'll just take it. So anyway, we'll go ahead and end this episode here because we ran it a bit long. So I've been Carne, this has been Skyrim, and I will see you in the next video. Adios.